5 years in the same place, doing the same work, it's almost like it's more than two decades. How has your experience been working for Porsche, working at Papillon, meeting so many people, initiating so many people? How has your experience been of 25 years of Papillon?
One thing, in calendar it was 25 years, no? But time has many dimensions. That's why Jesus has said that in the kingdom of my God there shall be no time. So when you are happy, the time flies. So there are two types of time. One is watch time or calendar time, and one is a psychological time. So if you ask me, it looks to me that as if I have come here just this year or previous year. No? It does not look to me that I have lived quarter of a century, 25 years. So that when I remember, I look at the calendar, yes, we have been here since 1990. But you feel time when you are unhappy. When you are serious, the time moves very slow. When you are with a friend whom you love, no, you don't feel the time. And when we are with somebody whom you don't like, even half an hour becomes so heavy. It looks as if you have been with the person for hours, no? So that way, the 25 years, I don't feel. It has just passed. And when I look at the calendar, yes, quarter of a century has passed. But I don't feel the time. I feel as if I have come here just few months back.
What was the main intention of opening this commune? And has this commune fulfilled that intention?
It was not a personal intention. It was instruction from my master. No, when he came here in 86 in Nepal, and he instructed me to build a commune on the outskirts of Kathmandu Valley. He has told me to open center in my first meeting in 69, and in several meetings in Rajneeshpuram and in Pune to start an ashram. But when he was here in 86, January 86, he gave me a parameters, a complete master plan. How should be the commune? He told me that it should be on the outskirts of Kathmandu Valley, not too far from the city, not too close to the city. It should be supported by nature. There should be plenty of water. It should be connected by metal road, and there should be electricity. So everything he told me, as if he knew this place. He told me that the meditation hall should accommodate 200 people. Your hall should accommodate 200 people for meditation. And there should be accommodation at least for 30 people, at least. More is better. No? So that was his instruction, and that was, he gave me the confidence and that it will happen. Otherwise, it was impossible to believe that it will happen in Nepal, looking at this financial situation, looking at other logistics. It was impossible that we will have even I travel around the world, even it is impossible in Australia or Canada to build a commune of this size. Even it is impossible in America, in England, wherever I go. I try to open a center, but it's not that easy. In Nepal, it was more difficult. But he gave me the confidence that it will happen. No? So when you trust somebody, that is a benefit of trust, and that is a benefit of a master. That if you have a master, and if you trust your master, his words gives you a confidence, and then you can channelize your total energy. So it has happened because of his command, and because he gave me the energy and confidence to do it.
Making a commune is not a small thing, and when you started this place, it was very not so developed, a forest land with few huts here and there scattered. And today it's become an international spiritual hub. So we have come a long way in 25 years. So you must have many memories which you cherish. Do you remember some incidents that you would like to share with us in these 25 years which are very important to you?
Yes, after he left in 86, a dedicated group of friends and dedicated disciples, a group of dedicated disciples, we started looking for the land. Although we didn't have money, we didn't have the support, but we started looking for land, and it took 4 years, from 86 to 90, to find out the appropriate place. For 4 years, we surveyed the whole outskirts of Kathmandu. Every Saturday, we were looking for land, a group of friends. But we landed at this property, and then it looked that as if Osho has seen this, because he has, whatever he has told, everything was available here. When we are looking at other property in Godavari, in the Khangali, in Thankot, I have traveled all in the periphery of Kathmandu Valley for 4 years. Almost every Saturday it was our job to look for the land. No? So, you know, in the hills there are so many limitations. If you have good view, there is no road, you can't reach there. If you have road, there is no water, you have to fetch water from kilometer. When there was no electricity, and somewhere there were neighbors, there is a beer factory around, or there is a leather factory around, no? So we were not getting an ideal place. When we landed here, it looked as if Osho has instructed for this place. This place met all his parameters, all his requirements. So everybody, we were in agreement that we should make our commune here. So when we first came from Zorba near main gate, just to go near this samadhi, there was no steps, so you have to hold bushes and then climb down. It takes several minutes, no, about 15 minutes to climb down, and more time to climb up. No? And it was infected by many wild animals, wild boar. We have spotted wild boars even in daytime. In this area, in the beginning, we were growing makai, corn. And many times the wild boar used to come. So we have spotted wild boar, we have spotted leopards, we have spotted a lot of deers and tigers. So it was very wild. It is still wild, but it is wild in different way. That time it was wild in a different way.
This is like an alternative society, and everywhere in the world, whenever an alternative society has come up, there has been a history that it has not worked for more than 5 years.
Mm.
So, but 25 years is a long time. Mm. And this is quite treasurable. Mm. So, how did Tapovan manage to along for 25 years? That also in a Hindu country, in a country that was very orthodox, that had orthodox systems of monarchy. So how was it possible that this commune managed to come 25
years? Yeah. Yes, it was also intention to create an alternative society. That's his dream about commune, and his dream about ashram. Because people, we unconscious people who live in the world, they create misery for themselves and create problem for others. And they create war, and they create conflicts, and they create a hell. So all the thinkers, all the seers like Buddha, Mahavir, Jesus, they all wanted a conscious society, you know, an alternate way of living where people could be happy without jealousy, without competition, without ego. No? So that was the dream of all the philosophers, all the seers, all the dreamers. Unfortunately, our investment in misery is so heavy. Try to understand what I'm saying. Our investment in misery and pain is so heavy that we don't want to come out of our misery society. No? So wherever this experiment was done, it has been done from the age of Sukrat. 2500 years, many communes have been built. Buddha made many communes. He called Bihar. All his Bihar were destroyed. All the Leo Tolstoy, Karl Marx, they all wanted to make a communes. Unfortunately, none of the communes survived. Mahatma Gandhi, when he was in Africa, he was very much inspired by this philosopher, and he wanted to create a Leo Tolstoy farming commune in South Africa, no? With great hope, with great dreams that everybody will work and everybody will be equal and everybody will respect each other's individuality, no? Mahatma Gandhi tried, but as you have said, all the commune survives. The whole history is a commune survives 5 to 7 years. Because human mind is such a stupid mind. We want to fight. People want war. No? People want misery. They want to invent trouble for themselves, and they want to invent trouble for others. Try to understand what I say. Our investment in misery is so heavy, we can't come out of it. So, whenever such experiment was done, it was destroyed by unconscious people. The commune were destroyed for two reasons. One reason was external pressure. External pressure of blind people who could not tolerate that a group of people become so happy. When we are so miserable with billions of rupees in our pocket, and some people are happy without anything, it is a great insult. No? For unhappy people, it is a great insult that you are happy all the time. So, indirectly, the external pressure was there. No? So, a lot of communes were destroyed, like Rajneeshpuram. It was destroyed. So, external pressure. And then, the greatest reason is internal conflict. The two reasons. Why communes have not survived in this world, the two reasons. One is external pressure, because unhappy people cannot tolerate that somebody is happy. It is a great insult. The first thing. And the second thing is internal conflict. What is internal conflict? When unconscious people gather together, they have their mind, they have their ego, they have their private plans, they have their private world. Everybody has a live in his private world. So if 100 people live here, there are 100 world living here. No? So this world conflicts. So everybody has his own dream, his own way of living, his own idea of living. That's why a leader is needed. That's why Osho never said, a commune president or commune leader. What a beautiful word he has selected for commune leader. Commune coordinator. What a beautiful word. People are not sensitive to see his intelligence. He has coined such a beautiful word. Commune coordinator. Who can coordinate between the 100 private worlds? Everybody, you have your own world. He see as our own world. I've got my own world, no? We live in our own world. We don't live in Tapovan. We live in our own world. But somebody should be needed who can coordinate between this 100 world and can make a minimum possible agreement so that people can live together. Minimum possible agenda. That is the duty of a that's why I also said coordinator, not commune leader, not commune president, coordinator, who can coordinate between minds. So if there's a good coordinator, the commune will survive. If he can coordinate between the mind, because every mind thinks I'm the most intelligent person in the world. And who can guide me? Who can teach me? Who can tell me to do this or do that? I know everything. No, that is the limitation of every unconscious, unenlightened mind, that the mind thinks that my mind is the best mind, and I can dream the best thing. I can plan the best thing. That's a human problem. That's a universal problem. Everybody suffers from this problem. Unless you become enlightened, you go beyond the mind, or you surrender to somebody who has gone beyond the mind, then you can live together. So Kavin survived till Buddha was in body, because everybody surrendered to Buddha and he was beyond mind. So he coordinated. It is not that they were not fighting. You don't think that you are only fighting. Bhikkhu have been fighting in the Buddha time also, in Mahavir time also. They were fighting, they were competitor, they were jealous, they were criticizing each other, because human mind is the same. No? But he could coordinate. So commune survived.
You've done quite a commendable job as a coordinator, keeping 100 worlds together, keeping 100 egos together in one place, and running it good is quite a commendable job. How were you able to do this? What are the qualities needed in a coordinator? I think because many communes are coming up now, and this would be a lesson. What are the lessons that you have learned in these 25 years that you would like to share with other people?
I'm learning every day. Every day I learn something. And every person brings new idea, every person brings new energy, and every person brings new problems, no? So you have to be very open, and you have to learn from everybody. Everybody has some original idea, and everybody has some original trouble also. So you have to coordinate between this. So I'm learning from people, I'm learned from the communes. Osho commune, which could not survive, Osho commune has also lasted 5 to 7 years. Rajneeshpuram lasted for four and a half years. In Pune, one lasted for exactly 7 years. No? When Osho came back again in Pune, he was there for three years. After he left his body, everything became muddy. So even Osho commune, and there were hundreds of Osho commune open at the time of Osho. We have a wonderful commune in France called Sargam. We had wonderful commune in Japan called Ira. We had wonderful commune in Australia called Mevlana. We had wonderful commune in England. So we had commune in Germany. Everywhere, hundreds of commune. They all collapsed. So I have learned from them how they collapse because of the mind, because of the ego. If I take care of my mind, and if I take care of my ego, that is the biggest challenge. So that what I have learned, that the commune leader should be very cautious, very aware. The first thing, he should discipline his own mind, and he should control his own ego. And then he should learn the art, how to play an orchestra out of the different mind and different ego. No, if you know the art, then it becomes an orchestra. No, otherwise it becomes a noise. If you don't know, you cannot discipline thing, then it becomes a noise. If you can discipline, it becomes an orchestra. That's the difference between music and noise. What is the difference between music and noise? Music is a disciplined noise, and noise is indisciplined music.
We've almost come to the end, so I would like to ask you, how are you planning to celebrate the 25-year?
Yeah, it's a great celebration for all of us. We are all are very excited, except me. I'm not that excited. But I have to pose that I'm excited because everybody is excited. Everybody excited, no? So it is an achievement. It is an achievement that we have completed 25 years. It's not a joke. It is a real achievement. A community existed for 25 years and has been growing. No, we are not existed. We are growing every day. There are a few communes who have existed 15 years or 20 years. There are a few surviving communes, but they are becoming less and less active. No? They are not growing. So there are two things. One thing is survival, another thing is growth. No? So we have achieved both. We have survived, which is not a joke, was a great thing. We have survived. And the second thing is that we are growing every day. No? So it is a big thing. It's a big thing for everybody. It is a big thing for the world. The whole world should learn how to survive together, how to live together, how to live in joy, how to live in celebration, how to live in community. It will become. Now you are living here, we are living here, we don't value it because anything which is very close, it is human tendency. If something is very close, you become blind about it. When time will pass, people will come to study how this commune survive. Maybe we will, after 25 years, we'll make a golden jubilee or diamond jubilee, no? Then people will come, and it is a task for social scientists to study that how a group can live together. It is not a joke, I told you, it is not a joke. That a group live together, an international community comes from people from different background, spiritual, religious background, economical background, psychological background, and they live together and they live in harmony, and they not only live together, they grow. So it is a achievement.
Please, don't be afraid, because I love Tapovan and Tapovan. I was with you in the creation of Usha Tapovan since 1990, and I've seen many people who has been the vehicles in creation of this Tapovan, and you're a very blessed person to be the vehicle of Osho, our beloved master, in the creation of Osho Tapovan. And I love Tapovan. And would you like to see something for all who are with you, supporting you, helping you in your life and the creation of this beautiful paradise, Osho Tapovan?
I'm not, existence does not do any favor. There's nobody extra blessed. Everybody is blessed. No, we all are very blessed. That's why we are here. No? That's why we are part of this commune. The problem is this, that we don't recognize that we are blessed. We think we are miserable. No? We are blessed, we are fortunate, but we are unconscious about our own fortune. We are unaware about whatsoever has been given to us. It always becomes meaningless. That is the human mind. Whatever is not available becomes so attractive. You want to achieve something which is not available. The moment you achieve it, it loses meaning. That's human mind. So everybody is blessed. But that is the whole function of this commune. To make you realize that you are not an ordinary being. You are a blessed being. You are not an ordinary person, but you are a sleeping Buddha. No? Any moment you can awaken. It is your decision that you don't awaken. Nobody can, responsible. You are your responsible. You want to be sleeping Buddha, fine, you sleep. But if you want to awaken, you can awaken any moment. No? So that is the whole message of Osho, that we all are blessed. We all are blessed one. And the moment we decide that we have to come out of this dream, that we are miserable. If you really decide to have to come out of the dream that you are unfortunate or miserable, from that day your dream will start disappearing. It is your decision, personal decision. So we all have to decide that we want to really become a blessed one. We are already, but we have to drop this illusion. This is illusion, this is a dream, no? That we are miserable. But lot of people, for them, it's very difficult to drop this dream outside this commune. That's why Osho created this Buddha field. That it is easy when you are with 100 happy people, 100 people with full of gratitude and love. It is easy for you to drop that you are miserable and you are unfortunate. No? When you see happy people, dancing people, celebrating people, loving people all around, maybe it will be easy for you to come out of your private hell. We all create private hell to live. We all live in our private hell. Otherwise, this is a paradise. But in this paradise also, we create a private hell to live. I told you, in misery, we have great investment. No? We have great investment. Whole life you have invested. That you have created a miserable life. No? So you don't want to come out from misery. Nobody wants to come out. I pull everybody, you know. But it's very difficult to pull them out of their misery. They create a private, even in this commune, which is a paradise, people live in their private hell. When they come, they bring their private hell with them. They live inside. I want to pull them out. They don't trust me. So, you have to understand this, no? That we have a great investment in unhappiness. Because whole world is unhappy, no? Outside world is unhappy and they think that they will be happy after they achieve something. Money or power or position or house, they think if they become something, they will be happy. This is a greatest confusion or greatest bhram, like one Englishman, illusion. The greatest illusion in the world that we think that after we achieve something we will be happy. This is illusion. Everybody has private goals, no? I have got 10 millions, it does not give me happy. 20 million will give me happiness, private goal, no? Somebody says, I am just a joint secretary, once I become secretary, I will be happy. No? Somebody has one shop, he said, I have a small shop, if I have a big shop, I will be happy. So everybody has a private plan that he will be happy after achieving something. To become, if I become something, I will be happy. This is a illusion. People don't want to come out of the illusion. And what Osho says that you are happy this very moment. And if you are not happy with 1 million rupee, you will be, if you are unhappy with 1 million rupee, you will be 10 times more unhappy with 10 million rupees. Try to understand. With 1 million rupees you are unhappy, then 10 million rupees you will become 10 times more unhappy. If you have a small shop, you are unhappy. With big industry, you will be big unhappy. That we don't understand and nobody ready to accept. We want to become. Everybody wants to become something, no? Everybody wants to become. This becoming is whole problem. Nobody is ready to enjoy his being. If you enjoy your being, you are happy this very moment. You see the small child, there are some child, they're always happy. They have nothing to achieve, but they are always happy because they don't have private hell. But slowly, the whole society trained us to create a private hell and live in that hell. So we all live in the private hell, and our objective is to break your hell and to bring you out of your hell and to make you realize that you are in a hell. Thank you very much.